Hello, beautiful Capricorns. This is your astrology and your tarotscope for February 2021. Let's jump into the reading and see what spirit and the universe has in store for you. Capricorn, we have the messages from Spirit that Spirit wants you to talk about or for us to talk about in this reading is peace. You know, most of you are very much at peace. I'm getting time for a nap, so catch up on your rest. But interestingly enough, you are observing something around you that is somebody else's drama. Somebody is coming to the edge. There's sort of this never-ending story. So we're going to look at that and see what that energy is. But that's a lot of drama. You seem to be more of a spectator than an active participant. So when I look at this reading, it's shock and awe. It's shock and awe. I love it for you. Capricorn, this is for Capricorn risings as well as sun sign. You are almost at the end of a cycle. Most of you who watch astrology know that Pluto, the planet of extreme change that's been going through your house for many, many years, is now really winding down energetically. For most of you, the transformation, the hard work, everything, the way you present yourself to the world, the way you look, for some of you, there may be tremendous amounts of weight loss. For others of you, it will be changing the way you speak, learning another language. It's absolutely like reinventing yourself. When we look at the energy of how you appear to the outside world, you're very serene. People like you a great deal. You have a tendency to attract very nurturing partners. This is the sign of Sagittarius. For some of you who may have been in separation from a partner, you are going to have a reconciliation. It looks as though for some of you, and I think this is what these cards are about, is that somebody who's been having a difficult time is finally coming to a time of peacefulness in their life. So you are watching them. You are supporting them. For those of you who have a Sagittarius partner or somebody with Cancer on their, you know, in their chart somewhere, things are really calming down. It's becoming a very good time for both of you. And if you're not in partnership, it does appear that a former lover may be coming back, a person who may have caused a lot of stress and anxiety. When we look at just romance isolated here, we can hop over to the fifth house. Three of water. You're like, eat, drink, be merry. I just want to be friends. I want to have a good life. All of this stability. You're really not about the drama. You sort of stand off to the side and let other people sort of have their meltdowns. But I'm getting right now that a lover or a child or something about your house of creativity, romance, sexuality, in which you're very happy, but it does look like there's some stress there. Mars is a planet of aggression. Uranus is out of the blue. It can be a fight that breaks out. You know, again, we have this never-ending drama and this come to the edge. Somebody wants you to do something and you're not really inclined to be affected by it. I feel as though for some of you, there may be the temptation on the part of a love interest to try to coerce you into doing something or making a big decision very quickly. I'm getting that for you. Look at this. This is like beyond words. Your second house of finance, your personal abundance, the money that you earn, the things that you value in your life, you are in a sweet spot that has not been available astrologically since 1962. We have not had this buildup in your now birth house, regardless of your age. We have you possibly signing a contract that is very creative. This also might be the energy of a creative project where there's a lot of drama that, you know, there's a lot of drama about you signing a contract for, you know, to publish something, to act, literally be an actor, an actress, a musician. But what we're seeing here is somebody is coming in. They want to make you a star. You are a star. It's Aquarius Empress energy. Your eighth house is somebody else sees you as an Empress. They see you as this exquisite manifestation, Leo energy, the house of the performer. So I would have to say that for many of you, some creative activity, some element of how you present yourself is gaining or gathering for you a whole new opportunity. This is something you've worked on for a long time. We see Saturn in your second house. You may even take a temporary pay cut or limitation to your income. But what we're seeing is long-term, this pays off in absolute exquisite abundance. Venus in your eighth house is you attracting other people's money through contracts, through goodwill, through your talents, through your hard work, through your professionalism. But you are rock star status, whatever that represents for each of you. Aquarius energy is very enlightened. Many of you may be writing with that Mercury. I would say that with Mercury retrograde, these decisions will not be made or finished, nor should they be till the end of the month. When I look at the energy of your third house of communication and contracts, again, there's a little bit of an observer look here. You should hold off. Neptune can mean something that would be unclear. In the worst case scenario, it would be deceptive, but I do not really feel that that's the case simply because it is well aspected. You are very intuitive, Capricorn. You really know sort of how to read the tea leaves of life. You are in this energy where, you know, this is not very highbrow for you. Everything that you're doing right now is very basic, you've aligned yourself with this energy. You have brought this in. The card that says that, you know, your ninth house of philosophy, of broadcasting, of publishing, you know, you're sort of just you're taking a break right now. You're getting some rest, which is what Spirit wants you to do. And additionally, you know, Spirit does want you to be peaceful because you have this exquisite energy, great happiness, rock star status, this Empress energy of creating abundance that may, you know, this may deal with being able to leave a legacy for family members or children or anyone with whom you would like to do that. The Nine of Swords says that you're at the final push-through phase of something that you have been creating for it to come to fruition. When we look at the energy of your fourth house of home and career, we see the Six of Air. You are moving forward. A new career. It looks as though you may be physically moving away to, and now we have a siren in the background. It's snowing in Chicago, so. But the Six of Air says that you are going to move boldly and quickly when the air sign, Aquarius, when Mercury goes forward, you may be asked to move or be somewhere very, very quickly. We get the Seven of Water. You have options. More than one person seems to be courting you energetically in your career. So it could be people competing, like an actor may have competing opportunities. Again, this is rock star status. When we look at whatever it is that you're doing, though, in your industry, in your field of endeavor, you have achieved a level of fame and fortune that is going to be with you until the day that you go, you choose, and you opt out to the next life. When we're looking at the energy of the North Node, the area in which you are actually learning, you are learning to be very, very stable energetically with your communication. When we look at your fifth house, again, we're looking at a romantic interest, a dear, dear friend who may feel very uprooted, may feel very tormented by what could be a challenge to a relationship. But I'm not seeing you. You know, this person would be willing to move with you. They would be willing to do anything they needed to do to be with you. The Two of Air says that they're just waiting for you to make a decision. They don't feel like it's their option or their opportunity. It's something that you're going to need to decide, you know, it's your decision. They, in this manner, are just just an observer in what's going on, but they're feeling stressed out, and that's what I'm seeing for you. The Justice card, again, that is Libra energy. That is writing a contract. Justice can be anything of legal nature. It is in your sixth house of everyday romance, everyday activity, your work life, your health. So it's Virgo energy. It's what you do every single day of your life. For some of you, you may be an attorney. You may be graduating from law school. But what I'm also seeing is that you're going to have great abundance. You may be asked to take a case that's filled with drama, that might hit front page news, that really could be quite out of the ordinary. Mars and Uranus energy, somebody who seems on the surface very stable, but maybe does something kind of wild and crazy that will hit front page news. You know, Gemini energy, justice. That's almost like, that's like reporting the news and what's happening to someone, like we saw the OJ trial. So it's very interesting energy. This can go a lot of ways. I'm throwing ideas out there that will be unique to some, won't apply to everyone, but I want to give you an idea of the various ways that predictions can unfold. Look at this is phenomenal. Your ninth house of law, of that which is an inheritance. So some of you could actually be inheriting money or a fortune from, I'm having a hard time. You can really tell that we have Mercury retrograde. But Wheel of Fortune here is Sagittarius, good luck. You have it, in the 12th house. What I'm seeing here is that behind the scenes, a beautiful legal deal is being negotiated. Again, Wheel of Fortune, you can't go wrong. The Wheel of Fortune is turning in your favor. This is a time when you're manifesting beyond possibly your wildest dreams, something that maybe you only dreamt about but never thought it could come true. The Two of Air says it right now. You won't see it coming, literally. You're just not going to see this coming. And when it comes, it will come. It's like that saying, go big or go home. Well, this one's coming in. Go. And it's saying to you, Capricorn, we're going big or we're going home, and we are not going home. So what Spirit is giving you, the ancients and your ancestors have sent quite a few messages for you. We have be an oracle, wait for important information, and we have the observer and the peace card here. Time for a nap, taking a break. So we see that advice here for you. Stand your ground. That's that sort of balance, justice energy here. Really staying balanced, staying calm, waiting for things to happen. Trust and thrive. Look at this. You are trusting and thriving. This energy also, if you're calling in a new business partner, they will be, or a new agent to represent you in some way, be it lawyer, be it a doctor, somebody who advocates for you legally, or a romantic marital partner. You are divinely protected. Surround yourself with protective energy. It's going to feel very chaotic. It's going to feel tumultuous at times. You're going to feel as though there's so much going on so quickly that, it puts you on the edge and it makes you feel uneasy. But we're seeing you divinely protected, divinely guided to an outcome that is exquisite, off the charts, unbelievable, which is so exciting for me to deliver that news to you. This can take a while to unfold. When we look at an astrological reading, we are looking that it would take probably the whole month of February, and it could take up until probably the time of Gemini, from May into June, to fully unfold. When we look at the advice from the Spirit Cats, Capricorn, we're looking at unique. Meet Helix. He was always a little different from the other kitties. At first, he felt lonely and alienated. He even considered trying to blend in and be accepted by the other cats, but he could not really ever give them the impression, or it would never give him the joy of being embraced for his true self. So he took a risk and met other people's gazes as himself. He saw that his uniqueness was his beauty, his spark. He alone could twinkle the way only he can. Miraculously, many kitties around him threw off their normal disguises and began to sparkle in their own way too. Their world became dazzlingly diverse. So embrace the freak within and remember that outsiders are in. And I want to add and tie this in because Aquarius is the eccentric. Aquarius is the weirdo. Aquarius is the person who's totally unique. And so we have Spirit Cat saying, give up the rest, you know, be the best, be yourself, be authentic. Your gifts are coming in. You already know that. I know that many of you know that because you've already been through this very, very transformative period in your life. Capricorn, if you would like to enter the contest, check the description box below. Number one way to enter is thumbs up the video, comment below so I can find your name and award a win to you. There's four free videos. If you don't want to do it that way, there's another way to enter in the description box, as well as find me for a personal reading. So sending you love from Chicago, send some back, Capricorn. Tell me what's going on in the comments and take care.